Erysipela. Erysipelas is a superficial skin infection caused by bacteria that characteristically extends into the cutaneous lymphatics. Erysipelas has been traced back to the Middle Ages, where it was referred to as St. Anthony's fire, named after an Egyptian healer who was known for successfully treating such infection. Historically, erysipelas occurred on the face and was caused by Streptococcus pyogenes. However, a shift in the distribution and etiology of erysipelas has occurred, with most erysipelas infections, 85% of them, now occurring on legs and with non-group A streptococci, sometimes being identified as the etiologic agents. Facial erysipelas exhibiting classic fiery red plaque with raised, well-demarcated borders can be seen in these pictures. Bacterial inoculation into an area of skin trauma is the initial event in developing erysipelas. Thus, local factors such as venous insufficiency, stasis ulcerations, inflammatory dermatosis, dermatophyte infections, insect bites, and surgical incisions have been implicated as portals of entry. The source of the bacteria in facial erysipelas is often the host nasopharynx or nose. Other predisposing factors include diabetes, alcohol abuse, HIV infection, nephrotic syndrome, or any other immunocompromising condition. Predisposing lymphedema is a clear-cut risk factor for erysipelas. Spread through the lymphatic system can produce overlying skin streaking and regional lymph node swelling and tenderness. The most common complaints during the acute infection include tenderness of the involved area, fever, chills, swelling. Death as a direct result of erysipelas is extremely rare. Predisposed patients often develop local recurrence, and this can lead to disfiguring and disabling healing reactions such as elephantiasis and nostris varicosa, can be seen in these pictures. In classic erysipelas, no laboratory workup is required for diagnosis and treatment. Routine blood and tissue cultures are not cost-effective because they have been extremely low yield and results have minimal impact on the management. Bacterial cultures from the portal of entry may be most helpful in persons with atypical clinical presentations. Elevation and rest of the affected limb is recommended in erysipelas treatment to reduce local swelling, inflammation, and pain. Saline wet dressing should be applied to ulcerated and necrotic lesions and change every 2 to 12 hours depending on the severity of the infection. Streptococci causes most infections by erysipelas, thus penicillin has remained the first-line therapy. Penicillin administered orally or intramuscularly is sufficient in most cases and should be given for at least 10 to 20 days. If allergic, cephalosporins or macrolide antibiotics can be used. Hospitalization for close monitoring and intravenous antibiotics is recommended in severe cases and in infants and elderly patients and patients who are immunocompromised. Patients with recurrent erysipelas should be educated regarding local antisepsis and general wound care. Predisposing lower extremity lesions like tinea pedis, toe web intertrigo, or stasis ulcers should be treated aggressively to prevent superinfection. Use of compression stockings should be encouraged for as long as 1 month in previously healthy patients and long-term patients with lower extremity edema. Long-term management of lymphedema is essential. Debridement is necessary only in severe infections with necrosis or gangrene. Follow-up. If not severe enough to be admitted to the emergency by the emergency physician, we should recommend very close follow-up, 24 hours for moderate infections and 48 hours for milder infections. We must make sure there's no progression of the disease. Come back to the emergency department immediately if you have progression of the discoloration, persistent fever and chills, or your general medical condition is deteriorating.